too much going on, it's just not realistic. These days I don't talk about them days like I miss them.
Y'all ain't ready? Y'all ready for this tea? Let's get it. What's up, YouTube? Today, I want to touch on this subject of riding with a trainer at a new truck driving company. Riding with these trainers, it got its ups and downs. Of course, you know, when you're a new driver going to a company, you know you're gonna have to ride with a trainer for a few weeks, maybe not, depending on your experience level. But eventually, some point in time, you might end up in the truck with somebody else. My opinion, me just going out with my trainer, he was a good guy. Taught me a lot of stuff, he was a pretty good guy. But as a trainer at a company, I mean, you're somewhat in a position like a football coach, basketball coach, you know, got to coach players along, always keep up good encouragement. Someone's doing something wrong, you know, let them know, hey, you're doing it wrong, bud, back off. Go ahead and take a break. Let me get it right. That's pretty much what a truck driver trainer is. He's there to coach you or to get your skills up to the level that the company wants you to be at before they put you in your own truck. So yeah, we can all agree to that. Yeah, that's not a problem. That's a no-brainer. He's there to make sure you're doing your job the way the company wants to do it. Okay. My experience, my training, yeah, he did that. He did exactly what the company wanted him to do. He got me where they wanted, showed me how to use Qualcomm, how to do the trip planning, you know, put the loads in, all that stuff. That's what a trainer supposed to do. But when you're riding, when you're training at a truck driver company and you out, you know, you're driving 500, 600 miles a day, you know, you just ride, especially on the interstate. It's just open road. So, like right now, I'm heading back down to my main terminal for the company I'm at. It's a long road. If I was in here with somebody else, you know, ain't no telling what kind of conversations we'd be having. That's the point of this video right here. The point of this video is not to dispute the way these companies want their trainers to train you. This goes above that. This goes above the company level when it's just a people level, person to person. Me sitting here driving, you on the passenger side, whoever you got in the back seat, anybody. You don't know, just passengers, period. You and that passenger. When y'all get up, when you get on that level, that's when stuff gets kind of iffy. Now, I know when I was in orientation at this company, we had to watch some little orientation videos, tell you about the company, tell you about the equipment they use, stuff like that. You know, all these different videos and stuff. One of these videos stood out to me. And I don't know if the orientation instructor, I think he might have elaborated on some parts of the same video. I can't remember it word for word, but I remember the basic parts of the video. Certain things you don't talk about with people you don't really know. If you're going to a company, any company, not even truck driver company, you could be going to fly an airplane. You could be going to pilot a ship. You could be going to a meat plant. I used to work at a meat plant, worked there for a long time. You could be going to a meat plant. But almost anywhere, you're going to have somebody training you on whatever type of industry you're coming into. You know, get this camera right. I had to get my camera view just right. Okay, anyway, you're going into a new industry. You're going to have somebody showing you the ropes, as they say, showing you the ropes, showing you what not to do. you know, while this person showing you the ropes, all kind of stuff might come up. You're going to get to know the person. Hey, man, you married, you got kids, you got a, where you used to work at, where you from. You know, normal shit like that, you know. But this, like I was saying, this video we watched in orientation, certain things you don't talk about with people you don't know. Race. Don't talk about race. You don't know me from Adam or Eve. Don't talk about race, especially if you're of a different race than the other person. Don't talk about race. Don't tell me what the Indians are doing wrong. Don't tell me what the white man's doing wrong. Don't tell me what the black man doing wrong, Chinese. You don't got to tell me what they're doing wrong, because you know what? You don't know. You don't know what I got in me. Hell, I could be part Japanese. I could be part Chinese. Don't talk about race. Don't talk about politics. A lot of people ain't into politics. I'm really not into politics. Only thing about politics I know is just seeing stuff on TV, you know. That's about as far as I get into politics. You know, I don't argue with it, but I mean, I know Republicans, Democrats, independents, everybody got different views, you know. Everybody's entitled to their own view. You know, so everybody doesn't want to discuss politics, especially with me as a black man. You know, we just had a black president. And let's say hypothetically, my trainer is a white guy. Let's just say that. I'm not saying he was a white guy, but I'm just saying, let's just say if he was a white guy, if my trainer was a white guy, I'm a black guy, as you can see already. And let's ask you this question too. If you were a black guy and your trainer was white, how would you feel if this person was always criticizing what the black president did? Black president ruined the economy. Black president wasn't creating jobs. You know, black president, he did this and he did that. Then come to find out he wasn't even black, he was Muslim. Bam, that's another topic you don't discuss with somebody you don't know. You don't discuss religion. Back in the old days, man, you had whole wars fought over religion. They're still fighting today over there in Iraq. You got the Muslims want to kill the Christians. Don't talk about religion. That's another thing you don't talk about. I done hit two things already. Politics, religion, race. That's three. That's three things you don't talk about with somebody you don't know. Talk about, if you going on a new job, you meeting somebody, talk about the weather. Talk about the football team. Talk about, I watch the damn Carolina Panthers. I'm in Kansas right now. Well, going through Kansas. I like Kansas City Chiefs. They're a pretty good football team. You know, talk about common things that you can relate to. Don't talk about sensitive subjects. Race, where was that? Race, politics, religion. Don't talk about stuff like that. I might be Muslim, even though I'm not a Muslim. And you want to talk about, this president, and he was a Muslim. Like, that's a bad thing. Hey, it's a lot of good Muslims out there. They're Muslim truck drivers. A lot of them. I've seen, when I was in truck driving school, I had a kid that was a Muslim. We stopped at a truck stop. We went inside to get some food and stuff. Everybody went in except for him. So I'm thinking, maybe the kid not hungry. I'm like, all right, maybe he not hungry. And then I already finished eating my biscuit. They were having some Hardee's biscuits. They was two for $2, excuse me, at Hardee's at a truck stop. So I already finished eating my biscuits. And I went back outside. Everybody else was still inside the truck stop eating. So I went outside. And actually, before I went outside, I went and got another biscuit. I said, maybe this dude might want a biscuit. You know, truck driver school, a lot of people, they don't have a lot of funds, you know. So I'm like, maybe he don't got the money for a biscuit. So I went and got him another biscuit. Came back outside, gave it to him. Come to find out, as soon as I came outside, he was over there on the side of the truck. He had his blanket. When they put the blanket out and they want to pray, you know, they got to pray certain times of the day. And I walked up while he was praying. And I seen him, I said, oh man. So I didn't say nothing. I just waited for him to finish praying. And then when he finished praying, I said, hey, man, I brought you a biscuit. And he was like, no, thank you, man. I'm fasting. I don't eat until sundown. So like I said, so there you have it right there. You got, but me, I didn't know this guy was a Muslim. I thought he was just a young kid, teenage. He was young, maybe 20, 21, 22. I didn't think he was a Muslim. So like I'm saying, you never know. You can't judge a book by its cover. So before you even touch on them topics of things you don't know about, it's best to not even bring it up. Tighten this camera up. I think I got it bad right. So anyway, like I was saying, don't approach subjects that you're not familiar, that you don't know the direction they're going to go. That's with any job, any company. Hey, you could be going to work on a golf course. You could have somebody showing you how to drive the little golf cart that picks up the golf balls. You don't know this guy. Just don't start bringing up random stuff, because you never know if that person is going to get offended or not by what you're saying. So don't bring that up. Another issue that you don't need to talk about, sexual orientation. And what I mean by that is, if I said the right word, sexual orientation, you know, you got a lot of people now, they want to identify as the other gender. But some people, they might want to keep that stuff a secret. In their heart, they might feel like they're a woman, but they're really a man. But you know, it's not our place to judge that. That's on them. You know, it's 2018, it's a new world now. I mean, I could change with the times. My last job, I dealt with a whole lot of company policies on how to treat people with respect, no matter who they are, no matter what color, race, whoever they were, you treat everybody with respect. Certain topics you don't discuss. That's four, I believe I hit already. Sex, religion, politics, religion. I think that's the main four that we hit on when I was in orientation. Now me, my experience, I go out with my trainer from day one. I met the guy, pretty cool guy. Like I said, he was good at his job. He was good at showing me the way the company wanted the job to be done. There wasn't no issue with that. That ain't what this is all about. This is all about us as Americans, us as human beings, not judging people by their covers. You know, treating company policies with how this company wants to adhere. Because you know, companies, that's a lawsuit. Stuff like that, man, that's just a lawsuit waiting to happen. You got somebody getting discriminated on, you know. You don't need to deal with stuff like that. But like one more time, this video is not about me bashing the guy who trained me, because that ain't what it is. But maybe he just needs to go back in for some sensitivity training, you know, so he can learn, you know, hey, don't talk about these topics. Don't discuss this topic with someone you don't know. You know, other than that, I mean, and you know, I kept it all the way professional. The guy, he bring up certain things, you know. I would talk around it. I'd be like, yeah, I changed the subject. Yeah, you know what? I'm here to do a job. I'm here to get my little training time over, move on to the next. I'm here to do my job. That's the bottom line. That's what I'm here for. I'm going to do what I got to do so I can move on to the next level. So like I'm saying, the man's a good guy. He just needs to sit down and evaluate some of the things that he says. That's the main issue. I kind of avoided most of the conversations because I didn't like the way they were headed. And then like, I didn't even mention about the Mexicans, you know. Right now you got the little revolution going on. Alright, I'm back. Had a little technical malfunction. Back to what I was saying. I didn't even bring up back to what I was saying. Right now you got a little revolution going on in Mexico. The Mexicans, Hondurans, Guatemalans, all kind of different races, they've been marching through Mexico trying to come up through the border. I think they might be right there in Tijuana or maybe some places down there. I'm not too sure, you know, truck driver. I gotta catch news here and there, you know. Might walk by the TV at the truck stop, see little stories on Facebook. But anyway, you know they got a little revolution going on in Mexico right now. I'm not Mexican, I'm black, but I don't discriminate no race. I'm not gonna tell somebody I don't know. Well, hell, Donald Trump will take care of him. Hey, I got nothing bad to say about Donald Trump either, but I'm not going to be pushing Donald Trump up on somebody I don't know. But anyway, hey, Donald Trump, he going to take care of the Mexicans. We'll put the boots on the ground. If they want to throw bullets, we throw them back. I soldiers kill anybody. Man, I don't want to hear that stuff, man. I don't want to hear that stuff. I'm not here for politics. I'm here to do my job, get my training over with. That's what I'm here for. Sex, religion, politics, race. Four. Maybe more things you can't discuss, but those four things right there stand out to me. Now, let's just get that out of the way and move on to another maybe simpler range of topics. Okay, let's say you're a truck driver trainer and you got a student on your truck. That student is on your truck, so you can train him on company policy, like I already said. That student is not there to drive the truck 600 miles, run his whole clock out. You know, anybody that, I'm pretty sure there's a lot of truck drivers watching my video. You got 11 hours you can drive in a day. Pretty sure most of you know that. The student is not on the truck to exhaust his clock, run over 600 miles, maybe 550, 600, depending on where you're at. That trainer is not on your truck to run 600 miles, exhaust his clock, just for you to hop in the driver's seat. And then you run some more hours. That ain't, maybe some companies do it like that, but this company I'm at, nah, that ain't how you do it. We're not teaming. We're not a team. I can't go back there and hop in a sleeper berth while you're driving. That ain't what we're doing. So yeah, if you're at one of those companies, that's not the way you're supposed to do it. Cause you know what? I can't learn nothing if you're sleeping or if I'm sleeping. You know, we gotta work together. You gotta be right there with me. Don't use your student just to get miles. You wanna run maybe 800, 900 miles a day just cause you got a student in there with you. Don't do that. Don't run your student to death. Don't run him 11 hours and then when he get finished driving them 11 hours, hey, good job, buddy. You did a great job today. That's a lot of miles. I don't need no praise for working. I'm 32 years old. I've been working my whole life. I'm an adult. I work. I don't need no praise to work. No, I don't need that. Don't do that. Don't use these trainees just to boost your paycheck up. Don't do that. If you're a trainer at a truck driving company, you're in a tight spot. And if anybody see this video and disagree with what I'm about to say next, I don't give a fuck. Man, we're not living in the 80s no more. If you got to take a piss and you got somebody on your truck, go to the fucking bathroom. Go to the fucking bathroom, man. Don't fucking hop up in the middle of the goddamn night and piss in a motherfucking bottle and leave that shit laying on the floor. Your trainee hopped down from his fucking top bunk in the middle of the night because he got a piss. So he hopped down at the goddamn top bunk. He goes outside the truck, piss in the bushes, go piss in the bathroom, you know. But while this trainer is hopping down from his top bunk, he accidentally steps on a bottle, feels like a water bottle up under his foot because it's in the middle of the night, you can't see. But you turn the light on, you see it's a bottle of fucking piss. Don't do that shit. Don't goddamn have 5-6 bottles laying around the truck with fucking piss in it. If you gonna piss in a bottle, don't piss in a bottle. But if you are gonna piss in a bottle, piss in a goddamn bottle that you can't see through. And even if you don't do that, put the goddamn bottle somewhere where only you know it, only you know where it's at. Put the motherfucker up under your pillow. Don't put the motherfucker behind the goddamn seat while the trainee's driving. And while the trainee's driving, he got a fucking bottle of goddamn Gatorade that he got down there between his legs. But he reached down and fucking find a goddamn bottle of Gatorade, and he reached behind the seat thinking it's the bottle of Gatorade, and he picked a goddamn bottle up looking for my damn coffee cup. Shout out Pilot Flying J. Anyway, don't do that. Don't let your trainee reach behind the seat thinking it's his Gatorade bottle, but when he pull it up, it's a bottle of fucking piss. Don't do that shit. Don't fucking do that shit, man. Don't piss in the bottle in the middle of the night while your trainee sleep. But you might think he's sleep, but he ain't really sleep. But he just tossing and turning. Cause you don't wanna idle the goddamn truck. Cause it's fucking oh man. Hey man, hey look. I'm a cool dude, man. I'm a cool dude. Hey, I like to joke and have fun too, but hey, this is just a topic that I want to put out there, man. Don't goddamn freeze to death cause you don't want to fucking idle the truck and it's fucking 23 degrees outside. Don't do that shit. Your trainee up there fucking tossing and turning, fucking cold, he can't sleep. Next thing he know, he hears some goddamn water running and a motherfucking smell, he starts smelling piss. He's like, oh, is that what I think it is? That smell like piss. And you look over the goddamn edge of the bed, you see a motherfucker pissing in a bottle. As soon as he pissed in the bottle, he put the cap on, put it on the floor. Don't do that shit, man. You want to be a goddamn truck driving trainer? Goddamn, do that shit the right way, man. Don't do it for the fucking money. Goddamn. Let me tell y'all niggas something. Hey, like I've been watching my man on Facebook, Nino Brown. I always say, hey, let me tell y'all something. Hey, he said, excuse me for saying that word, but hey, that's what he be saying. Let me tell y'all something. This little mount I just got from Walmart, it's pretty good, but the vibrations in the road and keep making the camera drop down. Hey, so you see, I mean, I'm lighting up a little bit, man. I'm not out to goddamn cut throats and shit, you know. I just want to put this stuff out there, man. If you're a trainer in a truck and you getting free showers every time you fuel up, cause you the one that's using the comm data card fuel the truck up. So I mean, the trainee's not getting free showers because you're the one using the comm data card to fill the truck up. So you getting the free showers on your love's card, your Pilot J card or whatever. So the trainee, if a trainee want to take a shower, he got to pay for it himself. A lot of trainees, man, they're not really making no money. They're not really making money. You know, they got families, they got kids, you know, stuff like that. You know, I don't got no kids. I mean, I got a girlfriend, you know, I don't have a wife. I mean, so I got a little bit of money where if I wanted to pay for a shower myself, I could afford to do it. But I wouldn't want to do it if I could get it for free. I mean, that's money I can save. So, you know, if your trainee wants to take a shower, don't. And let's just say this. If you're working on a flatbed, and you got to secure a load down, and you out there throwing chains, putting on tarps, putting on three tarps, 100-pound tarps in the hot-ass sun, you know, you out there working, man. You out there sweating. You ain't just sitting in the truck backing up the docks and no stuff like that. You out there fucking busting your ass, so you fucking sweating. Don't goddamn be like, oh, man, hey, the shower too full tonight. We just gonna take showers in. Don't fucking do that, man. If your trainee say he wanna take a shower and you got the fucking free shower on your goddamn love's card, let the motherfucker take a shower. Just cause you don't wanna wait in line for goddamn an hour until the shower open up. Shit, and you wait till the goddamn next morning. If the motherfucker say he wanna take a shower, let him take a fucking shower. Damn. Hey, y'all don't hear me though. Y'all don't fucking hear me. Hey, a lot of y'all motherfuckers gonna watch this video. y'all gonna hit the motherfucking dislike button. Y'all be like, oh man, that's new school, Nick. That new school truck driver. He don't know how we did it in the old days. We went 2 weeks without taking a shower. Man, fuck that. We ain't going no goddamn 2 weeks without taking a shower. If I been working in the hot ass sun, tarping down shit, putting on goddamn chains, I want to take a shower when I feel like taking it. Hey, y'all don't hear me though. Y'all don't fucking hear me. Check my navigation. 12 miles before I gotta make my next turn. 12 miles. I tell y'all, man, I've been on the road. I've been on the road probably about 2 weeks now. So I ain't drove a car since I came to this company. So when I first got this rental car today, it was like, man, I was hitting the goddamn gas too hard or hit the brakes too hard. I had to get used to it. I even had to get used to the mirrors. I still ain't got the mirrors exactly how I need them. I don't know if that's gonna do it. Yeah, I ain't got it how I want it, but hey, I can see my rear view pretty good. You know, I got it. But I got a 716 ETA where I'm going. 443 right now. Yeah, so I'm gonna get back down there where I'm going, do my laundry, fold my clothes up, you know, living in the truck past week or so. You know, I got stuff throwed everywhere. So I'm gonna go in there, man, edit this video real quick. I think I hit on most of the major topics of this video, you know, so I hope this video, man, like I said, hey, y'all that's gonna hate on the video and goddamn wanna talk shit or whatever, like, oh man, we didn't do this in the old days. Man, we ain't in the old days no more, man. It's 2018, it's a new world now. You can't discriminate against gay people. You can't discriminate on race, politics, nothing. If you want to talk about that stuff with your family. Don't talk about it with a complete stranger. Hell, you never know, man. I could have been a Republican. I could have been a Democrat. I could have been a Buddhist, Muslim, anything. I could have been anything. But you sitting over there on that passenger side running your goddamn mouth, you don't know you don't know who I am. You don't know what I'm capable of. Hey, don't fucking do that shit. Race, sex, politics, religion. Don't talk about that shit with people you don't fucking know. Point blank. I'm about to sign off on this. I'm about to find me a truck stop so I can stop and get some coffee with my Pilot coffee mug. And I'm gonna stop, get some coffee. I'm gonna use the bathroom. In a real bathroom, I ain't about to piss in no motherfucking bottle. That's what I'm about to do. Y'all hear me? All right, man. I'm out. Catch y'all on the next video.